Hey everyone, welcome back. Do you ever feel like you're stuck in a never-ending cycle of Netflix and DoorDash? Just because, well, let's be honest, the cost of living is skyrocketing and going out seems like a luxury these days. If you're nodding your head, yes. Well, you're going to love today's episode because I am going to show you how you can explore this amazing city of Indianapolis without burning a hole in your wallet. Trust me, you'll want to get off the couch and see what Indy has to offer, so stick around. Hi, my name is Kara Conti. I am a local realtor here in Indianapolis, bringing you another episode of Indy Vibe. First up is the Indianapolis Cultural Trail. It is an 8-mile journey connecting Cultural District to downtown. And guess what? It is absolutely free. You can walk, bike, or even rollerblade your way through vibrant neighborhoods, eclectic art galleries, and cozy markets. It's a fantastic, low-frills way to just learn more about some of the city's most interesting neighborhoods and local businesses. Who says you need a ticket to appreciate art? Sure, the inside of this museum is incredible, but the outer grounds, always free? Imagine wandering lush gardens, including an orchid greenhouse and sensory gardens. It's romantic, it's inspiring, it's Instagrammable. Number three. Now, if you are a fan of the great outdoors, you can't miss White River State Park. Right in downtown Indianapolis, this place offers a bunch of adorable attractions, including the Indianapolis Zoo, the Edel York Museum of American Indians and Western Art, and the Indiana State Museum, all of which have reasonable entrance fees. But you can also enjoy a totally free scenic stroll along the White River. Okay, before we go to number four, just quickly, I hope you're getting to know Indianapolis and the surrounding areas better with the videos on this channel. And like I mentioned earlier, I am a realtor here in Indianapolis, so if you are thinking of moving to Indy or any of the surrounding areas like Carmel, Fishers, Zionsville, all the suburbs, I cover them all. Well, do connect with me, reach out. I have my contact information somewhere on this video and for sure down in the comment section below. I get emails, texts, and some phone calls from you guys and I totally love it. So whether you're moving in 9 days or 90 days, do reach out. I'm excited to help. So moving on, book lovers, this one's for you. The Central Library. It's not just a library, it's an architectural masterpiece. The library offers free tours and it's gonna take you through the building's stunning architecture. You will see the grand staircase, the glass atrium, and also the historic reading room. It is an experience you're not gonna wanna miss. And like I said, it's free. Number five. Okay, let's talk about the Monument Circle. This place is right in the heart of downtown Indianapolis and is home to the iconic Soldiers and Sailors Monument. Want to know the best part? You can actually take a free guided tour and climb up to soak in some panoramic views of the city. Also, keep an eye on their event calendar. You can catch a free performance by the Indianapolis Symphony Orchestra. Talk about culture on a budget. Number six, next we're exploring the Canal Walk. This charming pathway is perfect for a leisurely stroll or a romantic pedal boat ride. You'll encounter public art, historic landmarks, and even some cool bridges. So whether you walk, jog, or float, this place is a visual retreat. Number seven, yep, Garfield Park Conservatory. So for those of you who are nature enthusiasts, you must check out Garfield Park Conservatory and Sunken Garden. Regular admission, well, it's just $3, but the Sunken Garden is absolutely free. So whether you're into exotic plants or beautiful fountains, this place is just a slice of heaven. Number eight. Now, if you're looking to unleash your inner artist, the Mass Ave Arts District is where you want to be. Street art, live theater, and shops you won't find anywhere else. The vibe here, electric. Number nine, Foodie Paradise. All right, foodies, I didn't forget about you. The Indianapolis City Market is more than just food stalls. It's a piece of Indy history. Plus, did you know that there are catacombs beneath it? You can tour them for a small fee. It will be fun during Halloween. Number 10, Fort Harrison is a dream come true for outdoor enthusiasts. Trails, fishing spots, and even historical forts, all for just a couple of bucks. You could easily spend a whole day here. And finally, number 11. Last but not the least, the Indianapolis Art Center. Now, this place is on a mission to inspire and unite the entire community through art. They offer an array of free and low-cost workshops. All right, adventurers, that wraps up our guide to exploring Indianapolis without breaking the bank. Whether you're an art buff, history nerd, or an outdoor fanatic, this city has something special waiting just for you. So what are you waiting for? Get out there and explore Indianapolis on a budget. Now, if you have your own favorite free or budget place that you like in the city, please put it down in the comments below. And if you like this video, please hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.